So in the last video, we looked at roughing this impeller out using 3+2 with an OptiRough strategy. Now that worked pretty good, but we're gonna take that part out, we're gonna put a new blank in, and look at doing this in simultaneous 5-axis with Blade Expert. So let's check it out. So here we have the part that we roughed in 3+2 using OptiRough. Now, the thing I wanna show here is that there's still quite a bit of material left in here. Despite this taking a while on the machine, it just, you really can't get in there and get the good access without doing a bunch of planes and coming from a bunch of different indexes. And to be honest, we'd probably have to add another index over what we did before, even increasing the cycle time more. So instead, let's look at programming in Blade Expert and see what's involved in Mastercam. Okay, so we're back in Mastercam looking at this twin flow dual-sided impeller. If I want to, I can go to the second view sheet and isolate the part. Sometimes it can make it easier for programming purposes, and I really like to use view sheets like this, especially for a complex assembly. So we have the previously programmed 3+2 OptiRough operations, and we kind of talked about some of the problems there. So let's look at what we can do with Blade Expert here. I'm going to go to the Toolpaths tab and launch a Blade Expert toolpath. From here, I will select the 3/8 ball and go down to the stock page where I will pick the impeller stock. From there, I'll select a cut pattern, and I don't want to use hub finishing here. In this case, we're roughing, so we'll set up roughing. And I'm going to do one way, and I'm going to start from the trailing edge and go from left to right. For now, I'll leave these depth steps and step overs a little bit larger just to make it generate a little more quickly. So this is where we can really see the benefits of Blade Expert. We're not defining different wireframe or different geometries while we're doing it. We just have to tell it what the part is, where the blades are, the fillets, the hub, and let Blade Expert do the rest. So let's do that. So I'll start by clicking the blades and splitter. I have this part color-coded, which is what I do for a lot of really complex parts. It really makes selection easy. I can select all entities by color, grab this orange color and this cyan, green check, that'll select all the blades with basically one click. End selection, I can do the same for fillets. Since those are a dark blue color, I'll pick that from my color menu. That gets all the fillets, end selection. Now the hub. With a single click, I can grab the hub, end selection. Basically, this has defined my part entirely. I can move down to tool axis control, and we'll be discussing this in depth in a future video. For now, I want to leave this at the default. Let's generate this toolpath. Now, our 5-axis Blade Expert toolpaths are going to kick out to the multi-threading manager. I'll open that up, and this is where I can see the progress of that toolpath as it regens. All right, so we've already regenerated here. Let's launch a verify. I'll go into my verify options and pick a stock model, and I'll use the impeller stock. Click OK. And verify. We'll turn this down and run it a little slower so we can see the motion happening. So this is where we really start to see the benefits of Blade Expert. It created automatic tool axis control strategies for us without selecting geometry or doing anything extra. All we did was pick the model, tell it where the blades are, what the hub is, and let Blade Expert do the rest. So with that initial rough done with the 3/8 ball end mill, let's regenerate this stock model. we'll come to the source operations and pick that blade expert operation that we had just created. I'll click generate toolpath and click OK. There we go. So with the stock model regenerated, I can click on this blade expert operation and copy it after the stock model. We can now create a rest roughing operation with blade expert roughing. I'll go into the parameters, go to the stock page, and choose blade expert 1. That's the name of the stock model that we just regenerated. From here, I'll go to the tool page and downsize to the quarter inch ball end mill. I can leave the cut pattern the same, with the exception of changing from right to left and come from the leading side. This is going to be going from the opposite side that the other one did. It allows some benefits for roughing on the machine. My part definition is going to stay exactly the same, and I'll leave my tool axis control page the same as well. I'll click generate toolpath and click OK. It will give me a warning that not all depths could be machined, but that's okay. We can come back and clean that up later. After clicking OK, we can see that it is indeed just doing the segments that had material left. It is a completely stock-aware operation. I'm going to do the same thing I did before, and now we're looking at Blade Expert 1 for our stock. Click OK and run a verify on this. I'll click play. And here's where we notice the tool is not cutting air. It's only engaging where there's material left from that previous stock model. So that looks like it verifies cleanly. Let's head over to the machine and see the difference of Blade Expert running versus that old Opti strategy we tried before. All right, with our roughing strategy figured out, let's move on to finishing. And we'll start with that center splitter and look at what we can do inside of Mastercam. To start programming a finishing operation, I'll go up into the multi-axis gallery and click Blade Expert. This will launch me into the parameters, and I'll pick the 1/8 inch taper tool here. For stock, it's not as important with finishing operations, but let's use impeller stock. My cut pattern, I'm going to be doing blade finishing here, and we're going to be programming that splitter. Now, I've got a couple options. I can do an offset from hub, an offset from the shroud, or a morph between the shroud and hub. This blade is not swarfable, as we talked about before. I'm going to use a morph between shroud and hub. For part definition, for our blades, we're only looking at that splitter. I'll use my color selector here, picking cyan, click OK, and end selection. For the fillets, I'll pick these 3 fillets down around the bottom of the part. For the hub, a single click will get me that hub, and the shroud is going to be these green surfaces at the top. All right, tool axis control, I'm going to pretty much leave alone. The one thing I can change is I can go down and allow some lag on the tool. So my minimum lead angle can actually be a negative number here. With roughing, we can't do that, or we'll be digging the bottom of the ball into the material, causing some serious chatter and some undesirable results. I'm also going to zero out the collision control here. We can add some back in if we find we have some issues later on. All right, let's generate this toolpath and see what we get. So really quickly here, I get some great results. Now imagine trying to program this with a unified. Getting that cut pattern on the part would be pretty easy. The challenge would become when we try to do the tool axis control. With unified, we can't really do as automated of tool axis control. We really have to control it with tilt lines or some geometry we draw. With Blade Expert, that's not the case. And one thing I really want to point out here is up on that leading edge. So if I go into Backplot and advance this along, you'll notice as we come across this front leading edge, Blade Expert does an excellent job blending that tool axis control across that edge. Now that would be a real challenge using a standard multi-axis toolpath. And this is where the real benefit of Blade Expert is when it comes to finishing. So now that we've seen the blade, let's move over to what Blade Expert can do for hub finishing. And I've already got that programmed in here, so let's just review the path. Really, the biggest difference here is going in, just as we did with finishing, and specifying hub finishing. The part definition really isn't going to change. You'll notice we don't really need any kind of shroud information here for this to generate. I'm just going to X out, and let's backplot this. So you'll notice that tool comes right across, moving between those blades really nicely. Again, I really want you to focus on the tool axis control that this toolpath has. That would be very difficult to replicate. Not impossible, but very difficult with a standard unified toolpath. Let's run this through Verify, and then we'll take it over to the machine and see how it runs. So in this video, we showed how programming the hub finish, the blade finish, and even roughing in simultaneous five axis on an impeller can be pretty easy. I mean, this was almost easier than programming a 2D bracket. In the next video, we're going to take more of a deep dive into Blade Expert, better understanding some of the intricacies of the toolpath, and some of the settings that can really give us more control over Blade Expert.